Hello friends, welcome back. Hearty welcome to you. Let us look at this problem. Solve for x. 5 into square root of 1 plus x plus square root of 1 minus x equal to 6 into x plus 8 into square root of 1 minus x square. Now we have to find out the real values of x here. We can try using algebra, and the other option is we can see whether we can do any appropriate substitution so that we can solve this problem easily. Now first let's understand what will be the range of x. Now if we want to have real values of x, then 1 plus x should be greater than or equals to 0. Similarly, 1 minus x should be greater than or equals to 0. And also 1 minus x square should be greater than or equals to 0. Now from this we know x should be between minus 1 and 1. Minus 1 comma 1. Now we can leverage trigonometry to solve this problem because we have some trigonometric ratios which are whose values are between minus 1 and 1. We know that sine and cos, the values will be between minus 1 and 1. So we can leverage either sine or cos to solve this particular problem. To move forward, I will take x equals to sine 2 theta. In that case, let us understand what will be 1 plus x and what will be root of 1 plus x. Similarly, what is root of 1 minus x and what is root of 1 minus x square, so that we can go back and substitute in the problem. What is root of 1 plus x? That is root of 1 plus sine 2 theta, that is 2 sine theta cos theta. But we know that we have an identity, cos square theta plus sine square theta equals to 1. So we can write down cos square theta plus sine square theta plus 2 sine theta cos theta. We have here a square plus b square plus 2ab. So when you take square root, we will have square root of cos theta plus sine theta whole square, that is equal to cos theta plus sine theta. Similarly, on the same lines, we can find out what is square root of 1 minus x. That will be 1 minus 2 sine theta cos theta, which is equal to square root of cos square theta plus sine square theta minus 2 sine theta cos theta. Now we can simplify this and we can write it as square root of cos theta minus sine theta whole square, which is equal to cos theta minus sine theta. Now once we have done with this two, let's do the last one. What is square root of 1 minus x square? That is 1 minus sine square 2 theta. What is 1 minus sine square 2 theta? Cos square 2 theta. Square root of cos square 2 theta, that is equal to cos 2 theta. Now let's go back and substitute in the given problem values of root of 1 plus x, root of 1 minus x and root of 1 minus x square to move forward. So we'll substitute the values and we will write down 5 into root of 1 plus x, that is cos theta plus sine theta plus root of 1 minus x, that is cos theta minus sine theta, is equal to 6 into x sine 2 theta plus 8 into root of 1 minus x square, that is 8 cos 2 theta. Let us simplify in the next step. We will have 5 into sine theta cancels. We will have 5 into 2 cos theta is equal to 6 into sine 2 theta plus 8 into cos 2 theta. Now we know 5 2s are 10, so we can write down cos theta is equal to 6 by 10 sine 2 theta plus 8 by 10 cos 2 theta. Now we need to get a relation between theta and alpha. So we have left hand side clear. But right hand side, we have to get it in the form of cos of something. We have to get, then I can take out the cos and I can get the relation between theta and alpha. For that, we will simplify this. We will take it as 3 by 5 and 4 by 5, and we will try to take another angle alpha and substitute the values here. That alpha, we have cos alpha equals to 4 divided by 5 and sin alpha equals to 3 by 5. So then in the next step, we'll go ahead and try to write down here cos theta equals to 3 by 5, that is sin alpha sin 2 theta plus cos alpha cos 2 theta. Now it is in the form of cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So we can write it as cos of 2 theta minus alpha. On the left hand side, we will have cos theta. So we have cos of theta is equals to cos 2 theta minus alpha. So we can write down theta equals to 2 theta minus alpha in principal value, or we can say theta equals to alpha. So when theta equals to alpha, now we can easily find out what is x value. X is equal to sin 2 theta, but we know sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta into cos theta. But we just now found out that theta equals to alpha. So why can't we go back and substitute 2 sin alpha cos alpha? But we know sin alpha cos alpha values because we know sin alpha is 3 by 5 and cos alpha equals to 4 by 5. So when we substitute that, we will get 24 divided by 25. So finding out x value by substituting with trigonometry is pretty easy when compared to solving this problem by using algebra. Let's have a recap of this problem. We have to solve for x, find out the real values of x given to us that 5 into square root of 1 plus x plus square root of 1 minus x equal to 6 into x plus 8 into square root of 1 minus x square. Now, 1 plus x and 1 minus x should be greater than or equals to 0. That means x value should be between minus 1 and 1. X value should be between minus 1 and 1. Then we can leverage trigonometric substitution of sine or cos trigonometric ratios. So we can solve this problem by using x equals to cos or x equals to sine. In this particular example, we have taken x equals to sine 2 theta. Now, after that, we tried to understand what will be root of 1 plus x and what will be root of 1 minus x and what will be the value of square root of 1 minus x square. We understood that by substituting the values, we get 10 cos theta equals to 6 into sine 2 theta plus 8 cos 2 theta. Now, we have to get a relation between, we have to get the value of theta, then only we can go back and find out the value of x, which is sine 2 theta. Now, since we have 6 sine 2 theta plus 8 cos 2 theta, after simplification, we are getting 3, 4 and 5, and we know 3, 4, 5 are Pythagorean triplet. So we leveraged that, we got cos theta equals to cos of 2 theta minus alpha. After simplification, we got theta equals to alpha. Now what we need to find out x, x is sine 2 theta, but sine 2 theta is sine 2 alpha. So sine 2 alpha is 2 sine alpha cos alpha, and we already know the values of sine alpha and cos alpha, that is 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. Substituting, we will get x equals to 24 by 25. Now you can substitute this on both left hand side and right hand side. You can cross check the answer. We'll get both LHS and RHS the value of 8. Both LHS and RHS equals to 8 when substituting x equals to 24 by 25. So that's one interesting example I just thought of sharing with you. Please do let me know your feedback. Thanks for your time and support. I'll catch you once again with another interesting example. Till then, keep smiling and sharing. Bye for now. Be safe. Stay at home. Stay safe.